Yes, Madam Speaker. The local government amendment bill before us was prepared en catastrophe last Friday. Indeed, Madam Speaker, we know that the cabinet communique announcing cabinet decisions every Friday when there is a bill coming, it's the first item, amongst the first items in the cabinet communique. Last Friday, indeed, the first item was, I quote, the cabinet decisions of the 23rd November. Cabinet has agreed to the introduction of an ombudsperson for financial services bill into the National Assembly and so on. And indeed, today, the first reading of that bill took place today, as announced in the cabinet communique. No mention at all about any local government amendment bill. I understand, therefore, that ministers and others worked very late Friday to get that bill ready to be presented, first, second, and third reading today before the Legislative Assembly. It would seem that this happened because government had been ill-advised that the village elections could be postponed without going through Parliament. This is my information, and that would explain why it is only last Friday, en catastrophe, that the amendment was prepared. It would seem that government had been ill-advised that village elections could be postponed through la présidence de la République. Anyway, it's clear that the bill was prepared en catastrophe last Friday only and circulated first, second, third reading today, which, generally speaking, we find unacceptable. This is not a way of doing good parliamentary work, certainly not. The bill has circulated. The bill that was prepared last Friday and that was circulated, it has been amended since, I'll come to that. But the bill did two things, et nous condamnons les deux aspects du projet de loi circulé, first, second, third reading, du projet de loi tel qu'il était à l'origine jusqu'à ce que l'amendement soit circulé ici. Deux aspects. Un aspect, un renvoi à 2020, whatever words we use, call a spade, elections were due this year, village elections were due this year, village elections have been postponed to 2020. That is the first aspect. And the second aspect was in mainmise total of government through the minister concerned. The minister was given the power in the original version, now amended, was given the power when there are vacancies at the level of the village council chairman, district council chairman, and so on, to appoint people. These were the two aspects. And we found both aspects, as far as the MMM is concerned, both aspects condamnable. And nous avons condamné. We use words and so on, but we condemn as undemocratic the two aspects that the original bill contained. And let me move, therefore, one by one. The question of du renvoi. Now, don't get me wrong. I am the first one to say that there have been in the past and there can be genuine reasons to postpone local elections. There have been genuine reasons in the past and there can be today or tomorrow genuine reasons. What kind of reasons? Well, if the village council elections, if local elections are going to coincide with general elections, obviously they will have to be postponed. If new legislation is being prepared, as was the case in the past, or if there is a catastrophe natural. So, yes, local elections have been postponed in the past. Not always for good reasons, but sometimes for good reasons. But what we've heard today, mon Dieu, no, honesty, the reasons that have been put forward today, honestly. I sympathize with the Honorable Minister who had to read those words. I feel so sorry, you have all my pity. The reasons put forward, there are a lot of legislation is being prepared. So we postpone village council election. Beaucoup de chantiers. Honorable Colin Davidou said that in a meeting during the weekend, and she picks that up. Beaucoup de chantiers, therefore, there's a chantier. No, let's be serious. As I said, you can have, if you're going to say general elections are 1-2 years away, say it, but don't come and tell me that it's good reason to postpone village elections, that there are a lot of chantiers and a lot of legislations being prepared. Rubbish is not very parliamentary, but this is genuine rubbish, Madam Speaker. And it's, I don't know why I heard Honorable Senator Ambou say, quote, where the Prime Minister confirmed that elections would take place. But in Hansard, you find it. It's in Hansard, I quote the Honorable Minister, Leader of the Opposition, didn't quote the whole part. Let me read. At committee stage, and it's not la fin du monde. In exchanges, Honorable Bhagwan put a question to the now Prime Minister, and this is what he said, I'll quote in toto, and it is in Hansard. Well, from memory, I can recall that we have made a provision in the budget for the holding of village council elections this year. But I will find out. It must probably be under centralized management of operations. Interruptions. It is here. Good. This is an answer. It is here. Good. So let's get ready. So what? This is in Hansard, and as I said, c'est pas la fin du monde. At that point in time, he said there is provision, there is financial provision, and get ready, because elections will be in 2018. This is in Hansard. So this is question of postponing to 2020. Nous condamnons, we don't agree. You have the required majority. I must say that there has been, I suppose this morning, a little manipulation of Le Mauricien, because I had heard that not only would the Miami's ministerial be done away with, which has happened, but I had heard also that there is going to be a precise date for the elections. And apparently this was leaked to Le Mauricien, because Le Mauricien, in this afternoon's edition, Le Mauricien says, get that, au moins une quinzaine d'intervenants, announcing, hein, Le Mauricien front page, au moins une quinzaine d'intervenants pour les débats sur le renvoi à des élections villageoises à, entre guillemets, not later than June 2020. So it was leaked to the press that not only la Miami's ministerial will be done away with, but not later than June 2020, which is not in the text, which is not in the bill before us. In the bill before us, it's 2020. It's not at latest June 2020. But it doesn't make a big difference. So this first aspect of things, I repeat, yes, there have been renvois of local elections in the past, some for bad reasons, some for good reasons. But this time, the reasons put forward are not serious at all. The second thing, la mainmise ministérielle, it's a good thing that government has come back, that has, I was going to say backpedal, but I don't want to hurt anybody's feeling. It's a good thing that government has backpedal on that. So the provision was that the minister, and I'm sure the honourable minister concerned never asked for such powers, but it was totally undemocratic. That during those 2 years, 1-2 years left before the next village council elections, whenever there is a vacancy at the head of a district council, of a village council, it is the minister who would, according to the bill circulated before it was amended, good thing, the minister who would appoint. If that is not undemocratic, well, I don't know what is undemocratic. And I appreciated so much la naïveté adorable du ministre. When she made mention to this backpedaling, did you hear? We all heard when she was expressing explaining the backpedaling, a good backpedaling. Sometimes you have to ride bicycles by backpedaling. She said, with this backpedaling, she didn't say that. She said, with this, doing away with la mainmise ministerielle, it means that now the chairman and so on will be democratically elected. you get my point. À l'envers, what does it mean? That what was being proposed was not democratic. And it's true. And definitely, I believe that this aspect of the bill was against the Constitution, was unconstitutional. As we know, every legislative or administrative action has to follow the condition. It must be reasonably justifiable in a democratic state. It was not reasonably justifiable in a democratic state that the municipal, that the village councillors, district councillors were no longer to choose, if there were vacancies, their chairperson, but the minister. Therefore, it's a good thing that government has backpedaled on that point, because I repeat, it was not constitutional. It would not have passed the test, but then village council elections will come within the next 2 years, so we would not have time to go to the Supreme Court and then appeal to the Privy Council and so on. But it's a good thing that government has backpedaled on this second aspect of the amendments proposed. So we are left, this has been done away with, we are back to where we were, good thing. We are left with this postponement to 2020. Call it what it is a postponement to 2020. I will conclude by saying I hope that a lesson has been learned. Preparing a bill en catastrophe, as was done last Friday, resulted in this mainmise ministerielle being provided for in the law. Good thing that government has backpedaled on that, and reference has been made to réforme électorale, financement des partis politiques, new declaration of assets act. Well, let us learn a lesson. Circulate the draft bills well before it comes before the legislative assembly. Let us not repeat what we have just seen. Un projet de loi prepared en catastrophe last Friday, and then one half of the projet de law was to postpone village council elections. This is being kept, unfortunately. The second half was to provide for in many ministerial. This has been done away with. Good. Well, allons tirer une leçon de tout cela, et à l'avenir, pour les autres projets de loi, circuler, especially the electoral reform bill, circulate as soon as it is ready, the fine print, the text of the bill, so that we have ample time to consider à tête reposée. Thank you, Honourable Speaker.
Thank you, Madam Speaker.